Hello, everyone out there, and welcome to Movie A Day with me, Kenzo Lee, on the Coochie Couture Network, or www.coochiecouture.com. Today is Oscar Day. It's February 22nd, and for today, I thought we would go on a little bit of location. We're in the Glendale Hills right now, overlooking Glendale in downtown Los Angeles, and also Burbank over here. And if you look on the far, far, far right-hand side of your screen, you should be able to see the outlines of Universal Studios. Don't worry, we'll get a lot closer later on. This is just a preliminary thing. Our movie for today, finishing off Academy Award winning week, is my personal favorite to win the Academy Awards. It may not be the one that you want. It's going to be The Curious Case of Benjamin Button. Now, I know what you guys are thinking. Slumdog Millionaire has a huge amount of a lot of momentum coming into this, and there's always the dark horse, like something like Milk is going to win it, but you know what? The Curious Case of Benjamin Button has all the ingredients to win the Best Picture prize. It has a beautiful love story, it has complications, it has amazing special effects. It's a combination of a really good blockbuster movie along with the art films that David Fincher is known for. It is, of course, directed by David Fincher and stars Brad Pitt and Cate Blanchett in the major title roles. The Curious Case of Benjamin Button is a milestone, in my opinion, in many ways. Not only is it a great acting job by Brad Pitt and by Cate Blanchett, of course, and the entire cast, but it is the use of digital special effects to make a full-blown character basically based upon a performance by an actor. It's the greatest combination I've seen of special effects and actor. I couldn't even tell seamlessly when they did it, and it was just prosthetic makeup. And it's very, very hard to tell the difference for the two. The film is a love story, which always does really well at the Academy. It is a film about a man who ages backwards. He's born at 90 years old, looking 90 years old, and ages backwards throughout the film, and about the girl he falls in love with who ages normally, and about the complications, of course, that arise. It's a very bizarre movie. It is not something that you know is really, really a typical film, and I think that's actually what's really interesting about it, because it is the generational, traditional love story passing through the ages of time. It's like Forrest Gump with a longer span of time, but with a different little twist to it. Obviously, you have an old man becoming younger, and he meets some great characters along the way, including an adopted mother who's like very protective of him, and then he meets his original biological father who abandoned him. It's a very, very good movie. If you guys haven't seen it yet, you really should check out The Curious Case of Benjamin Button. It is, in my opinion, the Academy Award-winning favorite. Slumdog Millionaire, in my opinion, is a little bit too risky, just for a little bit of that sense. Also, I believe that Milk is a little bit too risky as well. And I always believe that David Fincher does need to win an Academy Award sometime in his career. He's amazing. He's a great director. Seven and Fight Club are two of my favorites. So you gotta check it out. For Movie A Day, this is Kenzo Lee. You can check out all of our videos at Coochie TV on YouTube. That's COOCI TV on YouTube. Or on www.coochiecouture.com. And I'll see you later or at the movies.